In the Slocan area today, and we've been joined by Rick, and he's taking us for a tour of these mines up in this area. So the first place on our tour here is the Ottawa Mill. So we're gonna have a look at this mill, and there's a bunch of other mines in this area. We're gonna have a look at that. So we got a bunch of mines we're gonna check out, and we'll show you anything up in the Springer Creek area. There's about four mines we're gonna get to. We can show you what we find. So there's the Ottawa, the Arlington, the Meteor, and one other one that I can't remember, but we'll find them all for you.
Most of it's probably mental. You don't like dark places that are wet and you're claustrophobic. You have a bunch of phobias and stuff, but it's not gonna be the place for you.
Oh, that's pretty impressive. Not in too bad a shape either, as far as an old mill goes. Yeah, that was a pump. There's some nice little flotation tanks and cells here. Well, maybe it was actually rebuilt again at a certain period of time. Maybe they took the machinery out and then they put it back in. I don't know. So this is a froth flotation set up here. This is what they do is they put the minerals in here and then they agitate it and blow air in there and it makes a froth. And these skimmers just skim the froth off, which is where the gold and stuff is. So, yeah, pretty neat mill. Oh, there's a ball mill. Huh, nice big one too. Looks like the rats have been making a nest in there. What else do we got here? Oh yeah, this looks like the sodium metabisulfate went into this, they added it to the solution here. Somebody salvaged the boards. The price of lumber these days, no surprise. There's a big ore bin here. Yeah, let's get over to the other side. And this is one of the coolest little mills I've seen for a long time. Appears to be in pretty good shape. Let's see. We weren't expecting this. We thought it would just be some old foundations and stuff. And suddenly we find a pretty neat little mill. Lots of neat stuff here. This is a slurry tank here. I heard that the government leased this building, the Ottawa Mill, for the that housed up to 100 Japanese in here, but obviously
no, I don't think that's just an old wives' tale.
Oh yeah, yeah.
They're in Lemon Creek and New Denver and Sandon.
Yeah. Okay. So when do you think this mill was last operating?
Probably 50 years ago.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I would guess.
Nice shape.
It was built by lessors, actually.
Okay.
The Arlington was basically shut down around 1920, 1929.
Yeah.
Didn't open up again until the 40s or 50s. Probably ran for a couple of years, maybe.
Yeah.
This is flotation and ball, both.
Yeah, I see the ball mill there, yeah.
So that's the flotation tank right there.
Yeah, no, I see the ball mill there. Yeah, yeah, the ball mill's down there, yeah.
Yeah.
So where do you think that they got the ore for this mill?
Arlington and the Ottawa.
Okay,
that's right. Where you guys are going tomorrow, where we'll visit the access today.
Oh, cool. So this is a gold mine, mostly?
Silver.
Yeah.
Mostly silver, 200. It was originally 200 ounces a ton, both of them.
Okay.
So
they had probably galena in here,
correct.
Lead, zinc, silver.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
And a lot of these mines actually made more money off of lead than anything else, but it's not too sexy. People don't like talking about lead.
And occasionally zinc, too.
Yeah.
If you're close to the war.
So, yeah, yeah. Well, back in the day, the zinc was kind of a problem because
it was a big problem, particularly in the Sandon mines. So.
Yeah, lots of times they were penalized when they took zinc to the smelters because it was difficult for them to take
correct.
It out. Yeah.
Correct.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah, there's the ball mill, a nice little ball mill. Very similar to the one we see in Ainsworth, but similar size.
Really, that big too, man?
Yeah. Yeah, very similar. Oh, there's a crusher, primary crusher here. Oh, wow. Jaw crusher. A Pioneer jaw crusher. Wow. Look at the gate here. Got a really nice gate. Yeah. Looks like it almost worked. So this is a gyrating crusher, I think they call it a gyro. Yeah. Another type of a crusher. Oh yeah, this kind of articulates back and forth. Gyratory crusher is what that called. That's what that's called. Again, nice shape. Huh. Well, it's just great that we can document some of this stuff before it's all gone. I mean,
yeah, I mean, some of these 2 years ago, the last time I was here, and it's amazing how much stuff is gone.
Yeah. Well, you know, the REMAC was a good, or the HB mine was all pretty much all complete not that many years ago. You know, and we were just back there and it's completely burned. There's nothing left there at all.
Well, they burned it since last year, right? That what was left of it.
It's burned several times. Yeah, yeah. Look at this little gizmo. It's kind of pretty fascinating. So obviously what this did is it added a small amount of powder to a solution. See, this wheel went around. There's a cup in it. Can't see it now. And they dumped the solution into here with some water and then put it into this tank. So as it was running, a small amount of that powder or whatever was in, would add to the solution. Here's the other ball mill, so it's a pretty small one. There's the clutch that drives it, it's kind of interesting. Got like pads that drive it. Little miniature ball mill. All right, so we're at the Ottawa mine, which is we went to the mill yesterday, and this apparently has a whole bunch of different levels. So we found the adit, and we're just kind of looking around for some buildings. There's a big bin here with there was a compressor tank, but some people cut some of the steel out, used for something else, I guess. Big air tank, and there's a Deutz diesel. Are you the queen there?
The 100-year-old little steel.
Yeah, nice little chair. Let's see. Right by the mine. And it's supposed to be full of artifacts. Oh, look, there's a railway here. That was a good sign. Huh. That's pretty close in elevation to the other one. Similar kind of a gate. Lots of track here. Oh, there's a mine car. The bottom part of it. Looks a little collapsed. Makes it feel a little bit of air. Just enough to get you into trouble, I think. I think you could possibly dig that out. Not today, though. Somebody could dig that out. Let's have a look at the mine buildings. Well, that looks like a part of an electric mule. Electric train. Locomotive, what do you want to call it? Where the battery box is. Oh, that little shop in here to service the locomotives. You know what that was? Some kind of a milling machine. See too much of any real interest in here. Some engines here, all the parts are laying around. That looks like part of a locomotive. Yeah, that's what that is. Get in here without breaking our necks. Oh yeah, this is the wash house. Concrete floor, and a big trough there, so they call that the dry. The miners would have been in here. The shower's in here. Lots of waste rock here, so it's likely to be pretty substantial. Oh, not too bad. Yeah, it was only like a foot of water. The tracks are still here. We're gonna try to find some of these other levels later. And see what we can find here. Look, looks like there's some rats in here. Pretty cool wall here, Sharon. The foot wall. The hanging wall. The hanging wall, I guess. What kind of excitement to look forward to? How much swimming are we going to have to do? So this is a silver mining area. Not much gold here. Lots of silver though. Rick said something like 200 ounces to the ton. Pretty rich for silver. And there's a peg into the back there, they call it the back. And they put those in there so they hook up their airlines and whatever else. The airline's on the floor now, but the wire probably broke and it fell. So they just put little drill holes in there and then hammer those pegs in there. You can see that piece of wire to hold your airlines up. Water lines, sometimes power going back here. Or lights, or however they have it set up. There we go. There, it should dry again. They had a big air compressor outside here, so we know that they had lots of air going back here. I don't know, just to build a tunnel or to do some mining or what. That's what we're here to find out. Pretty straight, you know, so you can tell. You wouldn't think they're falling any kind of a drift, but that almost looks like a little quartz vein there, but maybe not enough to worry about. A lot easier than the mines we've been going into, the Monster Mega Mine. You have to shoot, gotta climb down 250 feet or something even to start exploring. For this one, you just walk right in, that's pretty easy. A little bit of water, but, you know, I don't know. If you're used to wet mines, it's not really a problem. I kind of prefer them over the hot, dusty ones. You know, down south in the desert there, which is really dusty, it's really hard on the lungs. And it's really hot in there, you're pouring sweat all the time. But here, it's just a perfect temperature. A little water never hurt anyone. I have a shower just about every night, I'm not scared of water. What is it? Your breath. It's the middle of July. These mines are not that far underground. They're not affected by the Earth's core. But generally speaking, the temperature in a mine is sort of the average temperature outside. So this being a more northern climate, you see, you know, cooler temperatures than you would down south. So that's what you'd you know, see, that kind of an average temperature. When you get down south, the average temperature is quite warm because it doesn't cool off much, so the mines are way hotter. Quite a long ways. I don't think you can see the outside anymore. Well, you can. You can still see the outside. Quite a ways back, eh? There's a tiny little deviation, but not enough to block the light. So I guess we don't need any paint just yet. Should be good for a while. We don't usually ever have to use paint or marking. It's just in the Monster Mega Mine being so extensive, it's kind of an exception. Well, I've got a bunch of quartz samples, drilling station. Yeah, just some planks. Yeah. Well, they had a diamond drill here, so they're doing some drilling in here looking for minerals. Kind of a nice looking sample, eh? Maybe a nicer museum. Looks pretty, doesn't it? Yeah. I'll stick it in my pocket. Maybe we'll climb up there on the way back. Have a look and see if it goes anywhere. Starting to get a little more interesting. an old chest. Oh, what is that? Oh, it's dynamite. It says 75%. It's kind of funny.
Oh my god.
Tiny sticks.
Little, yeah.
I would have thought it was putty, but it says 75% on it. Oh, here we got a bunch of track in here. Little storage area, small track. There's some electric blasting fuse. Don't see a blasting cap on it. Yeah. Not the skinniest little sticks of dynamite I've ever seen. Foresight, 75%. Well, there's a skip. Heavy duty one too. Yeah, we'll stick to the right since we don't have no ribbon. We won't get lost. Of course, you always say that. I don't think there's ever been a time where I said I was going to get lost and I did. This is really soft stuff. It does keep going, but I think we're going to end up, we're not going to go any further. We're going to end up in there anyways. Because there was a right-hand branch, or a left-hand branch. I don't think we want to go any further. Or didn't really even want to go this far. There's the next branch to the right probably joins up to where we are. This is all kind of falling down here. Pretty scary looking. See that square set there? Shine. Right here, there's a square timber right here. I think maybe this is the original way they went in, maybe. And that claps, and then the next branch just back there to the right. They probably went around it. We'll do that lots of times if we get into an area that is softer, it collapses rather than cooling out. We'll just go around it. There's a big pillar in the middle of this room here. Horseshoe. Going up to higher levels. That's interesting. Well, lots of possible places we can hike up to. It's really starting to branch out here, isn't it? Oh, lots of air here now. Timbered sections. Well, this is turning out to be a pretty cool mine. Another ore chute there. Again, we're going to stick to the right. Huh. Many, many branches here. Huh. Yeah. Footprints. Neat gate. The rays going up. Didn't look too crazy. What do you think about going up there? Wouldn't be too hard, would it? Might be an easy way to get to another level because it's like a man way there. Sometimes it feels, when you're going for a long ways like this, it feels like you're going to come up the other side of the mountain or something. Oh, there's stairs going up. That's interesting. Huh. Probably not in very good shape though. Yeah, this is pretty easy. Not very steep here, Sharon. Oh, there's a beautiful set of stairs up here. Yeah, come on up here. You're gonna have to go around them stairs, but yeah, this is this looks cool in here. Couldn't get any better than this. We're walking up. It gets a little slimy and everything, but them boards on here. Makes it really nice. Maybe one of the nicest set of stairs I've ever seen. This is definitely going to go to another level, I would think. I'll test this out. It's a little bit higher, but no, it's all good. It's a nice the way they built this. Pretty deluxe. Yeah. The only way it could be any better is if there was an elevator. I don't get too much further. It's a little collapse, that's for sure. Nope. She's blocked. Can't get through, Sharon. It's blocked. It's blocked. There's no way through. Too bad. We went back to the next branch and went to the right. This is just a little place where they would just park the empty muck cars, right? Put your empties in here and they take one at a time to fill up the face. You can see lots of water coming out of here. Air coming out of here, water coming out of here, and we can hear a little bit of noise. So we know there's water coming from the manway. That's an old style chute, isn't it? Look at the handle on it, let's see. Here's another cool gate. The manway beside it. Oh, well, that's the end of a deposit here. I want to feel the air. That was blocked off, so. Yeah, so they had a collapse up there and they blocked it off. The manway. Okay. Now we got another branch here. Some antifreeze. What they use that for is they put it in the lines to keep the girls from freezing up. In newer times, obviously. I'm just gonna have a little look up here. I think it's just a little storage area. I'm not gonna go anywhere. But I could be wrong. Yeah, it goes this way. There's one that goes to the right and comes right back where we just came from. But that wouldn't go anywhere. Seems like, you know, close to where the silver is, there's also lots of serpentinite because you see all these collapses where they were mining. And here's another one. Huh. But you can't really get any further. You get into this serpentinite. Seems like the silver ore might have been against the serpentinite. So that doesn't look very good, does it? I don't think we're going to get very far. Really loose and scabby. Lots of serpentinite here. It's all kind of collapsed. I see a muck sheet here, so that means it's probably going to be very close to the end. The muck sheet is where they blasted the rock onto. Yeah. First one we've seen so far. It looks to be in less than pristine condition. That's it. Yeah. So that's an aluminum airline. And they're cool because you can just pack them in and out. They're really light. It keeps coming this way. Probably goes around the end of that serp zone that we just backed out of. Trying to get around it. Yeah, lots of drifting in here. Huh. Maybe another chunk of aluminum line there. Huh, this has been a fun... This has been a really fun mine to explore. Oh yeah, there you go. There's aluminum from the top. So, huh, aluminum line going up there. Didn't look that easy to get up there. Well, we might be coming to the end of the drift here. Oh, there's a zone there. They mined out. Look at the head wall there. That's going to be end of her. That can be any easier getting up there.
I don't know about that. Maybe. We're gonna try to go up this little raise here. See how it goes. And then if it's good, I'll get Sharon to follow me. A little wet, but not too bad. Oh, the ladder's good. So far, anyways. Till the rung breaks. So hopefully this manway will go up to another level. Now this is where you gotta be careful with this stuff. Well, if you're gonna, I don't know. That's sketchy and shit. Nope. We ain't doing that. See that rock is barely sitting there. It comes down. Okay, watch out. I'm gonna push this down. Now maybe I'll try not to. Nope. Now I'm gonna come back down. It's too scabby. A whole bunch of loose rock up there. Over. Watch out for loose rocks coming down.
The way because they were already falling.
I could have maybe made it, but it's quite steep and there's big rocks at the top. They're just kind of barely hanging in there. So as I was going over a big rock, it might have come loose. What's that?
Let me move, please.
Okay, tell me when you're clear. I'm just hanging on a pipe here.
Yeah, well, I just got hit.
That aluminum airline goes up here. Kind of steep here, but then it looks like it flattens out. Might be a level, we'll see. Lots of loose stuff that can come down though. Especially down that slide. You're out of the way? Okay. If it wasn't for this pipe, I'd never get up here. Like a pole vaulter, huh? Might be a level here. Maybe not. A little steep here now. I don't know if that's a level now. Maybe. How am I gonna get by here? Lots of pockets going up. I don't think it's gonna go anywhere though. No, that's it right there. Let's see. And back up. Back. Okay. The Gopher Grand Forks, they call it. Pretty skinny. I'm not gonna go up through that. Okay. Turn around, go back down. Kind of steep here, all right. Oh, perhaps, huh?
bad too. Had a little hole there. Let's have a look at that hole, probably looking down the tunnel. Maybe even another way to get down. Everything seems kind of connected here. The timbering in here. Ooh. There we go. Oof. I bet you that's it. As far as going up places, I think we've explored all these connecting areas.
Thanks for joining us this week. We have a show every week, so we'll see you next week. Check out our new merch page. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Music is by the Addits.